Hello friends, welcome to techguru.civil, a channel dedicated to the civil engineering technology. If you like our videos, please give a like and share among with your friends. And please don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive all the notification. In this tutorial, we are going to deal with the single story residential building, how to draw the plan, front elevation and sectional elevation in AutoCAD recent version. Here it is the line diagram. This tutorial is divided into 7 steps. The first one deals with identification of partition wall and no wall portion. The second step deals with the wall layout. And the third, door openings. Fourth, window and ventilator openings. Fifth, dimension and label. And the sixth one, front elevation. And seventh, sectional elevation. In this example, the line diagram of a residential building is given. We need to draw the following things with respect to scale. 1. The plan at sill level. 2. Front elevation. 3. Sectional elevation along the section AA. 4. The schedule of openings. Here it is the line diagram of total dimension 9.14 by 12.07 meter. It consisting of several rooms where internal dimensions is provided. It consisting of 2 wall thickness. Main wall will be of 0.23 meter. Partition wall will be of 0.15 meter. And the floor height is 3 meter. Here the schedule of openings is already provided with some standard dimension. If not, we need to assume first step. We need to identify the partition walls and no walls. Usually the partition walls will be provided for storeroom, puja room, water closet and bathroom. For wardrobes there will be no wall. For portico portion no walls will be provided. Second step, we need to draw the wall layout. Third step, we need to show the door openings. Fourth step, we need to show the window and ventilator openings. Fifth step, dimensioning and labeling part. Once the plan is ready, we will go with the front elevation, then followed by sectional elevation. At last, we are going to prepare the schedule of openings. Step 2, wall layout. Before starting with the drawing, do some basic settings in the status bar. In the status bar, make sure that these properties should be on, like grid, dynamic mode, ortho, OSNAP, OSNAP tracking, line weight and transparency. Now go to the OSNAP, right click, click on the object snap settings and clear all the things. Now select only the endpoint, intersection, next extension and perpendicular. Click OK. Click on rectangle. Click D-Enter. Provide a size of 9.14 by 12.07 meters. Click. Press Enter again to repeat the same command. Click D-Enter. Size will be 5.18 by 3 meters. Select trim. Right click. Now trim off these two lines. Now select all the things and press J enter to join all the lines into a single polyline. Now select this line, click on the offset command, provide an offset of 0.23 meter and click it inside. Now select these two and explode it by pressing X enter. Now select the rectangle command. Click here and D-Enter, provide a size of 1.5 by 0.85 meters. Again, press Enter. Go to the endpoint, track it and provide a thickness of 0.15. D-Enter, size will be 3.5 by 3.325 meter. Again, press Enter, go to the endpoint, track it, provide a wall thickness of 0.23. D enter. Size will be 1.7 by 2.5. Press enter. Go to the endpoint. Track it. Wall thickness of 0.23. D enter. And size will be 3.5 by 3.325 meters. Now press enter. Go to this endpoint. Track it. You will get the intersection point. Click here. D enter. And size will be 1.5 by 0.85 meters. Click. Now right side portion is ready. Now let us concentrate on the left side portion. Again press enter. Click at this corner point. D enter. Provide a size of 2.75 by 3 meter. Click. Press enter. Go to this endpoint, track it, provide a wall thickness of 0.15. Next, D enter. Size will be 0.9 by 1.75 meter. Press enter. Go to this endpoint, track it, provide a wall thickness of 0.15. And D enter. Size will be 0.9 by 1.1 meter. Click. Now select all the things and press X enter to explode. Select the offset command, provide an offset of 0.23 meter and provide wherever the main walls are there. Okay. Again, cancel and select the same command. Now provide an offset of 0.15 meter for partition wall thickness and provide wherever the partition walls are there. Now press escape. Select these two lines and press J enter to join the line. Select these two, press enter. Select these two, press enter. Now select fillet or chamfer command with the radius 0. I will select fillet command and set the radius to 0 and select multiple option here and click on these two perpendicular lines. Okay. Now select the extend command by typing EX, double enter and extend it here. Now select trim, right click and trim off the unwanted lines. Note that the walls are continuous and there should be no line between the walls. So trim off the lines in between the walls. Now press escape, select the line command, go to this endpoint, click here and track this endpoint, click and join it here. Now here we have a column, so for that select the rectangle command, click here, D enter and its size will be 0.3 by 0.3 meter, click. Now click on the edge and select the solid pattern, click it inside and close it. Now we got the wall layout from the single line diagram. Now we got the wall layout. In the next class, we are going to learn how to provide the door, window and ventilator openings in a step-by-step procedure.